timelines, you can call it. So these timelines will be discussed. So once these are all agreed, budget, cost, deadlines, time, once this all is agreed, they will do a sign off. Once these are all agreed, the project is signed off, sign off, or you can say agreement. So now BSNL and TCS came to an agreement. So once they are agreement is done between TCS and BSNL, then TCS company will kickstart. Kickstart means will start the project. So this is the process, or this is the flow that is going on in the companies. Okay, companies will do a tender, and BSNL, say for example BSNL, and every company or service based company will enter into the meeting, and client give demos on the project and requirements as per him, and people will bid, and lowest bidding will be picked by the client, and this client and the service based company will meet together again, and they will discuss on all those things, how many resources they need, what is the budget, timelines and all. Once they come to an agreement, then they will give a sign off to the project, or some kind of agreement paper signings and all those stuff. And after that, I mean, you can say as business deals are done. Once that is done, TCS will start the project. So this is the flow that is being done in the companies nowadays, or I mean, this is a traditional thing. Okay. Next to this, so how this now starts the software development process. Now this TCS will start the development process. Okay. So what they will do, what are different software development models available in the market? So you might be aware, in your BTech or somewhere, we will have waterfall model, we will have V model, we will have iteration model, we will have some repetitive model, and these are some basic models that are available. Okay, so apart from this, recent model is agile model. Okay, so today let's talk about waterfall model. So what is this waterfall model is? For any software to be developed, there are certain phases that needs to be followed. First one is requirement phase. Okay. Next one is design phase. Next one is coding phase. Next one is testing phase. Next one is maintenance or feedback, you can say. So why this is called a waterfall model is, if you can observe, this is like a waterfall. That's the reason the name came as waterfall model. So what will happen in each phases? What will happen in each phases is, this requirement phase, what will this requirement phase will contain is, you have to know the, they will gather the user needs. User means we are the users who is using the application. So in this phase, gather the user needs. Requirements or needs are same. Okay, you will gather the requirements, and here you will design some blueprints like that, or some you can say architectures, or some design layouts, okay, like that. So once this requirement gathering is done, design will be made. Design means, I'll tell you live example. Say for example, as I was telling, BSNL needs some web application and all. So this requirement will be gathered in the form of documents or something like that from BSNL. Now coming to this design phase, blueprint or architecture means what SAS will do is, who will do the design is SAS and all, system analysts and all. So what they will do is, they will prepare some documents like I want web page like this, okay, and they will create some documents, okay, and they will tell us like I want my username should be in the center, okay, and they will put like I want my password here, okay, and they'll write some text here. Let me see whether insert. Insert text box. Username. Okay, so so this is just a sample that I'm showing, but they will design the documents like this. They may be Word document, or there might be PDF documents or Excel, whatever the layout that they are needing, as per the requirements, they will be designing some things like this, and they will be ready with the designs. That is what called the design, how the application looks like. So based on this design, developers will do the coding. Here the developers come then. Developers, what they do the coding. Next, here come the testers. We are the testers. So testers will start testing. So until the coding and deployment is done, they have to wait. So once this is done, they will deliver to us. So we have to test the code. After that, they will be releasing into the market. Once it is released into the market, if people are facing any issue, or if people are seeing any errors on the page, then they will give feedback, or then maintenance of the application will be going on. So this is called the waterfall model, which is very old model, and most of the companies are not following this, but it's better that you know this. So it will have a requirement phase where we will gather all the requirements from the user, and we will have a design phase where blueprints or architectures or designs are created, and after that coding will be done by developers, and testing will be done by testers, and here feedbacks and maintenance of the application. So that is how this waterfall model works. So let me unmute you people.
Unmuted.
Yeah, so that's it for day for today. I was talking from 7 o'clock, so we will wind up today. So I have given a basic introduction that you need to know when you enter into the companies. So these are some basic things you need to know, like SDLC models. So at least you need to know 1 to 2 SDLC models out of what is mentioned here. So like software development model, there is STLC also, software test life cycle. Development life cycle and test life cycle also is present. Test life cycle means what we do, what we exactly. Testers will have some development life. Testers will have their own test life cycle. So we will talk on that also. So this waterfall model is pretty old model, which is not being used nowadays, because until the coding is done, you have to wait for the code, and tester will be freely sitting in office. So that's why this waterfall model is not recommended. Now, nowadays, what is the companies following is agile model. Agile model is nothing.